Namaste, Jevin. I, Jevin Shobhakumari, assistant professor in Jyoti Vidyapeetha Women's University, Jaipur. Today, I deliver lecture on this topic, integrated nutrient management. First of all, I discuss about the INM. What is INM? INM means integrated nutrient management. Integrated nutrient management refers to the maintenance of soil fertility and of plant nutrient supply at optimum level for the sustaining the desired productivity through optimization of the benefits from all possible sources, this one organic, inorganic and biological components in an integrated manner. Fertilizers are usually classified according to the sources driven into two main categories. The first one is the organic source, natural, and the second is the inorganic soil, mineral or synthetic or man-made. Integrated nutrient management, INM, is one of the agronomic practices aiming at the uses of the harmonious properties of both sources by making a combination that can be used for the decreasing enormous use of chemical fertilizer and creating a balance between the fertilizer input crop nutrient requirement options, which can maintain the soil fertility, restore the soil health, and the continuous supply of plant with the nutrient requirement to obtain an optimum level of yield production, maximize the profitability, and subsequently reduce the environmental pollution. In conclusion, at last, the definition of integrated nutrient management is a low to no cost effective technology. What is low to no cost effective technology for the restoring the soil health as long as they can be produced and used within a same place? What is the concept related behind the INM? Integrated nutrient management is a practice that combines old and modern techniques of the fertilizer use and nutrient management. The idea of INM depend on a number of factors, including harmony in nutrient properties, a balance between the crop nutrient demand and what sort of the nutrient in general is available in soil and in the farmer's hand. Information and skill about the most suitable nutrient can be harmonized in a combination and which material can be safely used that lead to increased nutrient use efficiency. I told about the and I defined the terms nutrient use efficiency. You guys already know. Additionally, it is a method and way of disposing the organic waste safely and also effective method. Additionally, it is a method and way of disposing organic waste safely and also an effective method of recycling waste into good quality compost. The key components of INM concept include the following: increase the excessive use of chemical fertilizer and increasing them to focus on a long-term plan for sustainable agriculture. Moreover, farmer must have the greater consideration for the environmental impact and product safety food rather than the only focusing on the profit which can be obtained. It must always be remembered that the food safety is much preferred by the many customers regardless of the prices, and it can raise the farmer returns by the following such practices. Just like the first one practice is INM. I thought you guys well understand concepts and definition INM. Objective. The main objective of integrated nutrient management is to maintain economic yield for the long period with little effect on native soil fertility and environmental pollution. Making some changes in farm awareness toward the eco-friendly techniques, organic farming system. Organic farming system is generally eco-friendly techniques for producing healthy food free from the contaminant and ensuring the satisfactory economic returns. Advantage of INM eco-friendly techniques: enhance the availability of applied as well as the native soil nutrient. synchronize the nutrient demand of the crop with the nutrient supply from the native and applied sources, provide balanced nutrition to the crop, and minimize the antagonistic effect resulting from the hidden deficiency and nutrient imbalance, improve and sustain the physical, chemical, biological function of the soil, minimize the deterioration of soil water ecosystem by the promoting the carbon sequestration and the reducing the nutrient losses to the ground and surface water bodies and to atmosphere. System can improve the soil nutrient native and increase the solubility and availability of fertilizer to be used. Advance and sustain the physicochemical and biological function of the soil properties and minimize the higher total cost of production and raise the farmer returns, improve the resistance to both biotic and abiotic stresses. An effective method of agriculture practice to ensure healthy food covering the population's food demand alongside with the many soils and environmental impact, especially in countries with a rapid growth in population. Additional benefits can also be gained. It does not only save the total cost at the satisfactory level with an increase in crop production, but also can be easily practiced by the farmer. Therefore, it is considered one of the most promising techniques in line with the future needs. INM can have a positive effect on the susceptibility or plant resistance against many types of biotic and abiotic stresses. Guys, जो मैंने आप लोगों को पढ़ाया अभी या अभी मैंने explain किया regarding INM, तो आप लोग अभी तक तो समझ ही गए होंगे कि what is INM, INM के component क्या है. मतलब आज nowadays देखा जाए इस demand को देखा जाए तो क्या है कि population तो लगातार बढ़ती जा रही है और जो production है वो कम होता जा रहा है. तो farmers ने क्या किया, chemical fertilizer huge amount में use करना शुरू कर दिया. जब केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर ह्यूज अमाउंट में शुरू कर दिया, यूज करना सोइल के अंदर अप्लाई करना शुरू कर दिया, तो सोइल क्या हो गई, इरोड हो गई, पोल्यूटेड हो गई, डिटेरियरेट हो गई, सोइल की हेल्थ डाउन हो गई. इसकी वजह से क्या हुआ, सोइल हेल्थ डाउन होने की वजह से जो प्रोडक्शन है पर हेक्टेयर वो डिक्रीज होने लगा और जो केमिकल कंटामिनेंट्स है, केमिकल के जो पार्टिकल्स है, ये मान लो जो वो पार्टिकल्स या जो कंटामिनेंट्स है वो क्या हुआ, फूड चेन में इन्वॉल्व होने लगे और फूड चेन में इन्वॉल्व होने के कारण मैन के अंदर, एनिमल के अंदर बहुत सारी डिजीज को कॉज करने लगे. साथ में सोइल हेल्थ डिटेरियरेट हुई, प्लस ह्यूमन हेल्थ भी डिटेरियरेशन होने लगी. उसके साथ साथ देखा जाए तो फार्मर के पास इतने फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्सेज नहीं होते कि वो केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर खरीद सके और क्रॉप की डिमांड को फुलफिल कर सके. इसलिए ये इंटीग्रेटेड न्यूट्रिएंट टेक्निक मैनेजमेंट क्या है, एक इको फ्रेंडली टेक्निक है. इसके अंदर हम क्या कर सकते हैं, केमिकल, बायोलॉजिकल और फिजिकल मेथड. केमिकल जैसे फर्टिलाइजर हुआ, बायोलॉजिकल जैसे हमारा एजोप्टोबैक्टर हो गया, एजोला हो गया, ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी हो गया, और फिजिकल मेथड जैसे आप लोगों का एफ आई एम, ऑर्गेनिक इनऑर्गेनिक सोर्सेज. ऑर्गेनिक सोर्सेज के अंदर हम एफ आई एम यूज कर सकते हैं, कंपोस्ट यूज कर सकते हैं और आपका कंसिडर मेन्योर यूज कर सकते हैं. इनऑर्गेनिक हम केमिकल यूज कर सकते हैं. दीज आर दी जो एग्जांपल जो मैंने आपको बताया कि एजोक्टोबैक्टर हो गया, राइजियम कल्चर हो गया, कंपोस्ट हो गया और केमिकल यूज. तो इन क्रॉप की डिमांड को फुलफिल करने के लिए सारे सोर्सेज को हम क्या करें, एक कॉम्बिनेशन फॉर्म में हम यूज करें कि हमारे क्रॉप की डिमांड भी फुलफिल हो जाए और हमारा सोइल की हेल्थ, हमारे सोइल की हेल्थ भी डिटेरियरेट ना हो. इस तरह से हम क्या करें, इन सारे कंपोनेंट को हम एक प्रॉपर कॉम्बिनेशन में हम इसको कंबाइन करके हम यूज कर सकते हैं. यही इंटीग्रेटेड न्यूट्रिएंट मैनेजमेंट टेक्निक है. थैंक यू गाइस. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी, एनी डाउट रिगार्डिंग दिस सेशन, प्लीज राइट इन कमेंट बॉक्स.